And folks, welcome once more to OEW Ascension. I am, as always, the best-dressed man in pro wrestling, Dante, here with the Playboy.
Oh, Gracie, I would have been such an amazing mommy to you had you not gone to heaven so soon. I don't think you'd be where you are right now if I had been your mommy. Your daddy would still be here too, I bet. We would have loved you and spoiled you rotten. Too bad I wasn't your mommy. Too bad you had her.
What? This...
That's creepy.
Yeah, this Mysteria person is getting, like, more and more creepy each episode. I don't know what her deal is. This following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring first. Right here in Diamond Sands, standing 6'3", weighing 218 pounds, Steve Smith the Third. He tries. He succeeds more often than not, but he's got his work cut out for him today. And we have his opponent, who is coming to us from Outlaw Texas Wrestling. Making his way to the ring from El Paso, Texas, standing 6'5" and weighing in at 282 pounds, he is the all-natural Nate Erickson.
I'll put nothing natural about it. All the pain and suffering, there's beauty in the bleeding. At least you feel
something. I wish I knew what it was like. Now that hair is probably all natural. I wish I knew what it was like to find a place where I'm. Yeah, no, Phil, no beer during the show. Pete's sake, if I can't drink during the show, neither can you. Looks like Nate's all ready to fight already. He's not even getting in his corner.
Hey.
That looks like Nate's got something to say. He says, before we start, I just want to say how amazing I think you are, and your run as Diamond Sands champion was cut too short. Steve, thanks, man. After this, we'll grab a drink. Winner buys. Okay, well, looks like we have a wager on the line. Does that include everybody in OEW, Steve?
He didn't say it was only between them. So, winner buys the first round.
Awesome.
I mean, they can afford it. They're in the ring.
Yeah, that's true. All right, Bill, making sure both guys are ready. All right, and there's the bell.
There's the lockup. The test of strength.
Yeah, so I don't know too much about this Nate guy, but he's got about 70 pounds on Steve.
He's got the height advantage as well, so he's got the leverage and the weight behind him, but that doesn't mean anything. That just means that Steve's gonna have to do a few more strikes, ones that count.
Yeah, there they are, locking up again. Nate pushed Steve all the way back to the ropes. And there we go, Nate start things off with that wrist lock.
Yep.
Oh, look at Steve. Steve reversed it and got him into a hammer lock, and then to a headlock. Okay, so we're seeing a little more technical skill from Steve than we usually see. Nate managed to escape. Then a hip toss, but Steve rolling through it.
Like I said, he needs to go to his bread and butter. If he's going to take out this guy, he needs to go to his bread and butter, which is his strike. He's going to have to put Nate on the mat and not wrestle him on the mat. Oh, look, beautiful. Showing that
big
he
drop kick.
He's got some athletic ability.
It's always impressive when you see these really tall guys get airtime with a drop kick like that.
Especially at 280 plus pounds.
Oh, look at that. Nate just planting Steve with a shoulder block. Well, there we go. Steve with a drop kick right to the midsection.
Taking him down. Taking to his knees. Oh. That's not going to go. He hasn't done anything yet. You need to hurt the guy first, Steve, before you can...
We do appreciate that donation, Sydney.
Thank you, Sydney, for that support.
Oh, Steve. Steve trying to pick up Nate, but Nate's just throwing it right over his back. Now into a pin. Only a one.
How did he get out of that? Because he had him doubled over like a pretzel. Oh, well.
Huh? Steve may be rich and live a soft life, but he himself is not, definitely not soft. And they got a lot more than that to keep Steve down.
Big leg drop. Right across the chest of Steve. That's gonna take the breath out of you.
There you go. There's that striking ability Steve is known for, delivering a pair of kicks right to Nate's gut. A big snap suplex. And Rufus Tiger Paw, thank you for that donation.
Rufus, thank you for your support to the OEW. Much appreciated. Oh, that hurt Steve as much as it hurt Nate. I don't think Steve was ready for that extra 70 pounds.
Yeah, I don't think so. Looks like the damage was done, but Steve isn't able to capitalize right now. One of these guys better get up and do something.
Surprised the ref hasn't started a 10 count. Both men on the ground. Well, Steve's up to his feet first. Here comes Nate. Up to his feet. What is Steve doing?
Is Steve gonna... Oh, no. I think I see what Steve might be thinking. Nate's all shook up. Doesn't look, you know where he is. And, oh boy, there goes Steve up to the top rope.
I rent high reward. Or yeah, hide it faster.
Steve better be careful up there. Oh, or like that. Steve hesitated just a second too long, got caught with a fireman carry as he came off the top rope.
And high pain. And there goes, he's down for the pin. Ref, that was a three. That was a three. But the ref says it's only a two. I counted three on that one.
Well, you know, Bill, yeah. Bill's getting beer regardless of who wins this match, so.
And somebody rolled out a can for him earlier, so he's already drunk. Into the ropes. Beautiful Hurricanrana. But again, it's doing more damage to Steve than it is to Nate.
Jeez, I think both guys are down again.
I guess they're going to kiss and make up. Little cuddle time on the mat. And there goes the pin.
Nope, still only a two count.
He didn't hook the leg. He didn't have the leg hooked. He tried for that touchy-feely pin, and it's not going to work. Gotta hook that leg.
Now, both men back up. Steve trying to get some momentum here.
And he got big boot for Charles, but I think he rolled through.
Steve manages to duck underneath that boot at the last second. Oh, and there goes a dropkick from behind, sending Nate Erickson into the ropes.
This is where Steve has to capitalize. Or it's over.
Oh, there goes Steve with that, the devil lock DDT. I've never seen that move before. Oh gosh, he just planted Nate's forehead right into the mat, and then goes for a pin. 1, 2, 3.
I've heard that's his finisher, the Diamond Sands delivery.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, that was. This is what happens when you only have 6 hours of sleep.
And
here's your winner by pitfall, folks, and fine drinks for everybody. Steve the first.
And you have a reporter. You own fine drinks.
Helping Nate back up to his feet after that match.
It is the night. My body's weak. I'm on the run. No time for sleep. I've got to ride, ride like the wind. Truly free again.
And that's his debut for
the El Paso
Beat.
I was born the son of a lawless man. Always fought my mind with a gun in my head. Let my life
turn
down ten, but run like the wind, yeah. And I got such a long way to go to make it to the
border of
Mexico. So I ride like the wind, ride like the wind.
That match is sponsored by Hollybrook. Hollybrook, the family, is a family proud avatar and LGBT family farming life kit. They've got eatables, my brain is just not working today.
Making his AEW debut from Lansing, Michigan, standing 6'8", weighing in at 267 pounds.
Scream, piss off, screw you when it talks to you like you don't belong. It tells you you're in the wrong field when something's in your mitochondria, cause it latched on to you like knock knock, let the devil in.
Benevolent
as I've ever been, head is spinning, this
medicine
screaming,
lick,
let us in it, lick, like a solid ball, let your Allen Poe head written, should have been dead a long time ago.
He's up from Lansing, Michigan. I'm guessing a lot of poutine and other things from Canada.
Wow. Now let's go to the bottom of the country. And introducing his opponent from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Standing 6'1", weighing in at 235 pounds. Parker. Oh, boy. And just another mismatch.
I'm starting to agree with you on this one.
It's 7 inches and almost 30 pounds different. Wow.
Yeah, but Parker has power of fashion on his side.
Yeah, but it's still not as good as us.
I mean, I don't know. Retro is in. Everybody likes the 90s and 80s vaporwave look.
Mama's boy. Oh, hell. Yeah, there's the bell. And it's a stare down.
No, look at this. I'm not so sure about Parker's chances here. I mean, I don't know too much about this Eli guy, but he doesn't look like he's probably the nicest of people.
Well, he's a mama's boy, so that just took away his man card. Parker may have a chance since Mama's in the house. Trading off hammerlocks. Keeping each other close.
Yeah, Parker has been on a win streak lately, so, you know, despite his odd fashion choice, which, you know, odd is in a good way, I like it, he's been doing pretty well.
Yes, yes, more of the punching, please.
Now Bill calling for Eli to open his fists when he's throwing those punches. It's called avant-garde fashion. Gosh, you're right. You're right, Playboy. These audience members, they are just underachieving. They don't know anything.
I mean, he looks better. He looks 10 times better than Barbie does.
Exactly. This suit did cost thousands of dollars. Anyways, there's Parker off the ropes with a big boot taking Eli down.
He's got something. Got him picking him up. What's he have in store? The ropes. Beautiful
drop kick.
Beautiful drop kick.
Appreciate the donation there, Zoe.
Oh, thank you for supporting the OEW.
Well, you know, Eli hasn't managed to put up much of an offense yet. Parker's been dominating this match so far.
What do you expect from a mama's boy?
Oh, and there's a pin. One, two. Nope, only two.
I can see that shoulder up, but he. He's big enough, he can run right through. Oh, there you go. Oh,
We have another big drop kick from Eli. And it's always kind of scary to see these really big guys fly. Ooh. Or move around like cruiserweights.
That's gonna hurt. That's gotta take a little bit out of Parker's. That DDT.
Yeah, I'll knock the wind out of his sails.
To the ropes. And the mama's boy got. Oh, nice drop toe hold. Parker wasn't expecting that.
Nope, that was a good counter.
Got in there front lock.
Oh, what a big neck breaker. Looks like he was just trying to pop Parker's head off like a cork.
Yes.
There's the pin. Only two.
Wow. What does Mama's boy have in store now? Sending him to the ropes. He's coming back. Parker lays him out with a spear.
Surprised Bill's not counting faster today. He probably wants those drinks after the show.
He's just thinking about those drinks.
Well, here we go. Parker with the figure four leg lock. Eli using that great height of his to reach out and grab the ropes immediately. And Bill's starting to count. Parker's got till five to break it.
So far, this has been a back and forth battle between the two. Mama's boy to the ropes. Oh, to the corner.
Well, here goes Parker. He's pummeling Eli upside the head.
But
Bill trying to call Parker out of the corner, but after punching Eli in the head, now he's just bouncing Eli's head off the turnbuckle.
I think he's trying to make some scrambled eggs. Oh, he's going to be working on that knee. Take away a wheel. Take away a wheel.
That is an illegal hold.
Yeah, it's not illegal.
Well, technically it is, but you know, you shouldn't do it when the ref is watching.
It's called tactics.
All right. Parker finally dragging Eli out of the corner. There, look out, Bill.
And the damage has been done to on that knee.
Parker making Eli pass out with that sleeper hold and going in for a pin. One, two, no, only a two count.
Thomas boy woke up from his nap too early. He's got to choke him out.
Eli trying to stomp, trying to get some momentum going, countering out of that wrist lock. A big code breaker. I think Eli might be stunned after that one. Going for another pin attempt. One, two, and three.
Is your winner of the match? Parker, the one. The loser of the match, Mama's Boy.
Well, Eli said he didn't want to misbehave in front of his mom.
Yeah, but words to box in front of his mom. That's even worse. Nobody wants that.
From Swansea, Wales, standing 5'11", weighing 190 pounds, he is the OEW Diamond King champion, and same one, Alex Pineda.
So I am out here to issue an open challenge for my Diamond Sands Championship. If anyone backstage thinks they're crazy enough to face the insane one, then come out here.
Open challenges are always bad. You don't know who you're gonna get. And looks like we got another champion answering this.
Oh boy.
Looks like Monkey Daishin, the hardcore champion, is going to answer this challenge.
Hang on. Shut the music. Monkeen would love for nothing more to have another belt in his possession. So, buddy, when you call the devil has a way of responding, and you just called the devil. So, let's see what you can do to try to defeat Monkeen, because I guarantee you he'll be coming out here with that belt. That belt is his.
Strong words from his manager. But I don't doubt his words. I know Monkeen can back those up.
Let's go, Monkeen. Make this quick.
Oh, yes. Monkeen definitely can back up anything Lex says. All right, folks. Looks like this match is underway. Going to be underway. You know, we have Monkeen Daishin, 5'9", from outer reaches of Mongolia, hardcore champion. So this match is for the Diamond Sands title. This ought to be an interesting match, because we all know how brutally vicious Monkeen is. We all know just how crazy Alex is.
But I think the brutality may prevail on this one. The back.
Oh, what a nice ground and pound from Monkeen. You know, Monkeen doesn't say very much, but he doesn't really need to.
Oh, he speaks volumes in the ring. His actions are louder than his words.
Definitely. Come on, Monkeen, you got this. You got this, Monkeen. Take this guy out. Take his belt. Take everything.
He lets his fists do the talking for him. Or Lex.
It's either hot air or hard punches. One of the two.
Oh, Alex off the ropes with a Styles forearm.
You're nothing, you little punk. You got that? You're nothing. Come on, Monkeen, kick his ass.
Going up top again.
Alex with that diving hurricane runner.
Ouch. I'm surprised Alex is actually taking it to this, the hardcore champ.
Well, I mean, it's not a hardcore match, but you know. Again, Alex, if there's anybody who can probably match, like, insanity and craziness in the ring with the Mongolian, it's probably Alex.
Well, Monkeen does have a little bit of a weight advantage, but not much of a height advantage. They're basically even. This is one of the few evenly, probably most even matches today.
True. You know, both these guys are longtime wrestling veterans. And, oh, Mankin with the Mongolian missile dropkick.
Excellent work. Excellent work, Mankin. Keep at it. Keep at it. You got this. That belt is ours.
Alex taking a second to rest in the corner, but no, Mankin right on top of him, bashing Camino's head into the corner.
Ow. Up in the air one too many times.
Yeah, you know, that's why I'm just kind of you know, I'm obviously a Team Lex guy, but you know, in this match you got two people who really like to hurt other people and don't really care if they get hurt themselves doing it. Mankin back down on the ground with that grounded pound.
Yes, yes, more of the punching, please.
Yes, Monkeen's checking the integrity of the corners.
Yeah, he's just making sure everything's fine and safe.
That's right, ref. Do your job like you're supposed to. Make sure those turnbuckles are safe.
But I don't need to free this time.
There goes Alex, and it's being sent into the corner.
Alex is perched on the top rope. Mankin trying to go up. Oh, beautiful drop kick. Nailed him.
Come on, Mankin, get up. Get up.
Both these guys are just like tearing each other apart this match. I don't know. You know, whoever wins, there may not be much left over.
You can call it a hardcore, non-hardcore match?
I guess so.
Both men are standing. Oh, and Mankin rolls through.
Oh, looks like Bill got taken out by Mankin by accident. Oh, Bill's definitely going to need some of those beers now.
Oh, if the ref is out, the ref can't see what goes on next.
Bill trying to get back up. Now Bill somehow wandered over into the corner where Alex is. The heck? I don't think Bill knows where he's at now either.
I don't think he ever knew where he was at.
Yeah, you're probably right. Alex with a missile dropkick, and Bill gets taken out a second time. Oh boy, Bill's having a really bad day.
I guess he really needed that shot of tequila for the match.
Oh, he's definitely gonna need several.
And there goes Mankin. Taking advantage. Going to the outside. And what's he going to grab? Looking under. Lots of toys down there.
Yeah, who knows what exists in that strange void under the ring. Wait a minute. What's Axel Santiago doing out here? Axel yelling at Mongolian. I don't know what he's saying, though. Mongolian just got speared by Axel. Okay, come on. What the heck is going on? Axel's not even involved in this match.
And those two are fighting.
Well, Mankin better pay attention to his match and not to Axel.
The ref is down.
Yeah, but still. His match is with Alex, not with Axel.
Those two are fighting in front of Gomes.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know where the heck the Marquine is going. He needs to be back in the rig.
Axel, your hits are landing like Nene's does. Soft. Alex is in the ring all by himself, just trying to wake up the ref. And Hero, thank you for supporting the OEW.
Yes, we definitely appreciate that. Looks like Monkeen has disappeared backstage with Axel. And it's just Alex and Bill in the ring. It looks like... Monkeen might have lost his temper and went after Axel. And now he's gone from the ring. Bill is starting the count out.
At the five.
Lex, go get Monkeen and drag him back out here. The 8, 9, 10. There you have it. Monkeen Daishin has been counted out. Oh, that was a travesty. Alright. Your winner by count out is still Diamond Fans Champion, Alex Camino.
You know, what happened out here was nothing more than disrespect towards the hardcore champion. That guy needs to be taken back somewhere. I don't know who the hell this Axel thinks he is. What do you want? Ugh!
What the hell?
That's what he wanted.
You know, okay, first we get Axel out here getting in Monkeen's business. Now TJ Aquilis out here just because he got beat up last week by Lex in a hardcore match. What a sore loser. You know what? You know, are these guys taking lessons from Johnny Angel and minding their own business? As in they have no idea how to do so?
Of course they are, but that's called a receipt.
No, go check on Lex. Make sure he's okay.
Actually, better yet, drag his ass to the back. Look, let's keep this show going. And here comes Monkeen back to get to his he must have taken out Axel. In the back, because he's helping Lex back up.
You're the man I'm supposed to meet. Maybe you can tell me what I'm doing here. Wait a minute. Wait, I know who you are. Aren't you that guy who threw that Carney promoter off this cliff?
Yes, I am that guy. And the next time you pull a stunt like that during my show, you'll be dealing with something far worse than being thrown off this cliff. Paul Slater, I brought you here for something else. You're looking for something. You left SL Wrestling never to come back. But you came back for what was it again? Oh yes, to find that piece of shit who said all those horrible things about you.
You know who that piece of shit is. Is that what you're here to tell me?
Before you say anything further, Paul, I'm here to tell you that your search is over. I'm that piece of shit you're looking for. You see, what? I knew your ego and your pride were too strong for you to sit back and not come to find answers. I put things out there about you so it would get back to your friends, your family, God knows whoever else, and they would let you know. You're here for a reason, Paul Slater.
I'm here for a reason. And for what reason would you want me back?
I've been following you for a long time, Paul Slater. You have a way of connecting to people, even the ones who hate your guts. You're the voice of the people, and a voice that I find could be very valuable for OEW. I heard exactly what you told Tiesa last week. You did what you had to do to get where you are. What did you call it again? Being a scumbag. We need someone like you here, Paul Slater. Someone a scumbag to push the people in the right direction. A voice of the people. Now, what do you say about that?
Listen, I'm going to tell you the same thing I told Tiesa last week, all right? I don't care about OEW. I don't care about his fans, and I sure as hell don't care about the cesspool community of SL Wrestling. The only thing I care about is me. So what's in it for me?
Well, we can always see what the bottom of that cliff looks like. I don't know, but the water looks cold.
Whoa. Easy there, easy. I think you may have misunderstood what I was saying. What I really meant to say is, I'm really looking forward to working with you, sir.
Then, welcome aboard.
Oh boy,
Mr.
we getting
Slater.
Paul Slater back? Yeah, I mean, I'm excited about that. I used to work with Paul back in Premier Wrestling. You know, I met him when he first started in the business, and you know, this will be great. I think he'll be an excellent addition to OEW. Well,
oh, yeah.
A re-addition to OEW. All right, so, falling contest is scheduled for one fall. First, making his way to the ring from Detroit, Michigan. Standing 6'8", weighing 281 pounds. The whole damn package, David Van Dam.
And introducing his opponent from Tulsa, Oklahoma, standing at 6'11", coming in at 340 pounds, the living legend, J.W. Easley.
Hey,
resist. Well, I think today David Van Dam has his work cut out for him. That's right. You know, we've seen DVD take on several people, varying degrees of success. But now he's facing a longtime veteran in J.W. Beasley.
But these are two big men, so this is going to be a big fight. Both can take the punishment. Both can deliver damage. This is going to be a fight. That's going to be heard it around the ring. And there's the lockup. The test of strength, the test of wills, and which one will prevail.
I think if David Van Dam tries to play the strength game with J.W. Beasley, he's going to lose. David calling JW a fat boy. Oh boy, that's not a good idea. JW at that monkey flip. That was, you know, okay, so here's the thing about JW Beastwing. He might be a bigger guy, but he's pretty agile for someone who's almost 400 pounds.
That is true. All we see is a little dancing going on between these two big men, not any wrestling. I don't think it's Dancing with the Stars over the edge. It's over the edge wrestling. So, come on, guys. Show me some blood.
I mean, DVD really think that was gonna work? Look behind you, Bill. Really? Did Dave, oh, really? Bee's nuts. Did he really just say that?
He most certainly did.
Hey, DVD better be glad I'm not in charge or he'd be fired for that. DVD going for a couple of pins, actually starting to hold his own against JW.
think JW will have an offense of another guy looking at his at his nuts.
Well, you never know how they do things out in Oklahoma.
He rolled the dice and rolled snake eyes. JW is finally showing some offense now.
Yeah, well, JW is tough, so it's going to take a lot more than a few punches and throwdowns to take JW B-Swing down. JW with the pin. One. Nope, only one. David Van Dam showing some resilience.
David, your ass is a living legend. What?
Well, man, I thought this was a family show, but I guess not. David Van Dam with another pin.
And just a two count. Just like his inactive career. Almost, but not quite. Off the ropes. Beautiful clothesline. Taking the big man down.
DVD say it's time to end this. Oh boy, what does he have planned? Is he really? David Van Dam just picked up JW B-Swing and pile-drived him. What the? JW B-Swing's almost 400 pounds. How did that happen? DVD is holding his ribs. I think that did more damage to him than it did JW. Oh, JW coming back with that Polish hammer. God, you know, this just shows how resilient JW is. He just shook off that pile driver like it was nothing. JW going in for a pin. One. No, still only one. And you know, JW is a former tag champion. He did here in OAW and the European champion. He's a lot more experienced, but David Van Dam does have youth and energy on his side.
this entire company has a lot of youth, but it's got those veterans to that can show those useful guys a few tricks of the trade.
Yeah, that's one thing I think makes OEW pretty great. They have a big mix of new talent and longtime veterans. JW thrown into the corner. Oh, what a big turnbuckle thrust to the ribs.
And the big man's down in the corner. David needs to DVD needs to capitalize on this, or he's not going to get another chance. That big man gets up. I don't think he's going to be able to take him down again.
Oh, DVD with that elbow across the leg. That's a good strategy when you're fighting a much bigger and a heavier opponent than you, is take their legs out.
Can't quite work on three wheels. Give that a bad wheel. Downhill from there.
Here goes DVD with the pin. One. Two, no, only two count. Uh-oh, DVD arguing with Bill. Nope, that's never a winning tactic. And JW crawling away trying to recoup. Bill arguing back with David Van Dam. Oh, David Van Dam, he made the crucial mistake at SL Wrestling. He turning his back on his opponent. Here we go. Oh! JW with that big tiger suplex. Now JW's got David up by the hair.
He's just massaging his neck. Otherwise,
JW has David in the sleeper hold. David is struggling. He's flailing. He's trying to get out, but he's fading fast. Uh-oh. I think David's starting to fade. Bill checking on him. It's twice now Bill has checked David. Gets him a third time. This could be over. Here he goes, grabbing the arm. Uh-oh. David has gone down.
David has hit.
Oh, there you go, folks. That's it. David Van Dam is out. Your winner by submission. The living legend, JW B-Swing. Well, it looks like experience won out over youth today. You can be as energetic and skilled as you want, but once you get that blood cut off to the brain, you're done. All right, folks, and that has been our show to... Wait, what? Wait a minute. What? What is that? I know that music. That's David Hawk actor. What? Hey, what's David Hawk actor doing here? The president of wrestling. Wait, is that the OEW title he's holding? What? What the heck is going on here?
Looks like we may have our interim champion.
Yes! Patriots! Your eyes do not deceive you. Your elder statesman is here, back in Over the Edge Wrestling. Back when I was the first ever OEW World Heavyweight Champion, you had a champion who always put America first, every single day. And as I fought to become a five-time OEW champion, I was a champion for the blue-collar workers, a champion for the truck drivers, for the oil field workers, and every American who believes that hard work is better than government handouts. Unfortunately, since OEW's return, you've had world champions who were selfish and only wanted a gold star to put on their resume. But thankfully, for all of us, I was called to fight for truth, justice, and the American way once again as the world champion you deserve. And it's time to make wrestling great again. As your new six-time OEW World Heavyweight Champion, I will do everything in my power to remind you and the world why your real American hero, DHA, is pound for pound the greatest wrestler ever. And that starts next week as I'm scheduled to face some mascara guy. I don't know. Maybe he's into makeup. I don't know his name. Now, some of the brainwashed liberals might think DHA as your world champion is just temporary, interim, just for a while. That once Owen returns, he'll save the masses from this Trump-supporting DHA. But every moron who believes that couldn't be more wrong. If Owen returns, he is going to have to get in line and go one-on-one with the icon. And when the world title is on the line, everyone will tell you, I will do whatever it takes to win. And despite what you may read on social media or what the biased news networks may say, DHA is the greatest thing that ever happened to pro wrestling. This campaign is just beginning. So God bless America and nowhere else. And a quick message for all you snowflake liberals out there. DHA is your World Heavyweight Champion again. Get used to it.
You know what? This is amazing news. I think OVW has just got a lot more patriotic and a lot more American.
Yeah, right.
I wonder how long it's going to be now before Johnny Angel shows up and like, that's not how world champions act, eh? It's like, dude, be quiet and stay back in Canada where you belong.
Yeah, but you got to
remember. It doesn't matter, folks. If you don't like it or not, DHA is our interim champion. So he is your champion.
Interim means temporary.
All right, folks. Well, this has been another exciting episode of Ascension. Want to thank all of you for coming out today. Thank you for donating to us. We definitely appreciate it. All right. So, folks, make sure you come back and see us again next week. Same time, same place. As always, I've been the best-dressed man in pro wrestling, Dante, here with the Pro Voice. and we're gonna go get Bill for the several beers that we've been paying for. Rest of you, have a good rest of your weekend.
And you're welcome.
When you think it's over, then we rise like a phoenix from the ashes and dust. Rise like a demon, we will not give up. We rise up, rise up.
Countdown initiated. Launch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go.